In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Good morning, brothers and sisters. Today we offer this Holy Mass for this parish community. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, King of David, Lord have mercy. Christ Jesus, Morning Star, Christ have mercy. Lord Jesus, God with us, Lord have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who sent your only begotten Son into this world to free the human race from its ancient enslavement, bestow on those who devoutly await him the grace of your compassion from on high, that we may attain the prize to true freedom through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord God, the Holy One of Israel, O people of Zion who dwell in Jerusalem, no more will you weep. He will be gracious to you when you cry out. As soon as he hears, he will answer you. The Lord will give you the bread you need and the water for which you thirst. No longer will your teacher hide himself, but with your own eyes you shall see your teacher, while from behind a voice shall sound in your ears, this is the way, walk in it, when you would turn to the right or to the left. He will give rain for the seed that you sow in the ground, and the wheat that the soil produces will be rich and abundant. On that day your flock will be given pasture, and the lamb will graze in spacious meadows. The oxen and the asses that till the ground will eat silage tossed to them with shovel and pitchfork. Upon every high mountain and lofty hill, there will be streams of running water. On the day of the great slaughter, when the towers fall, the light of the moon will be like that of the sun, and the light of the sun will be seven times greater, like the light of 7 days. On the day the Lord binds up the wounds of his people, he will heal the bruises left by his blows. The word of the Lord. Blessed are all who wait for the Lord. Praise the Lord, for he is good. Sing praise to our God, for he is gracious. It is fitting to praise him. The Lord rebuilds Jerusalem. The dispersed of Israel he gathers. He heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. He tells the number of the stars. He calls each by name. Great is our Lord and mighty in power. To his wisdom there is no limit. The Lord sustains the lowly. The wicked he casts to the ground.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord is our judge, our lawgiver, our king. He it is who will save us.
Alleluia.
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 The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus went around to all the towns and villages, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom, and curing every disease and illness. At the sight of the crowds, his heart was moved with pity for them, because they were troubled and abandoned, like sheep without shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest." Then he summoned his 12 disciples and gave them authority over unclean spirits to drive them out and to cure every disease and every illness. Jesus sent out these 12 after instructing them thus, "Go to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. As you go, make this proclamation: the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse lepers, drive out demons. Without cost you have received, without cost you are to give." The Gospel of the Lord. The Lord reminds us in today's Gospel that we need to evangelize. We need to announce the good news. This is the first word of mercy, the first word of love for other ones. Love for God and love for other ones. We need to announce the good news, the gospel. All the world needs to listen to the word of God, because in this word we found the last goal in our life, the last goal in our existence. And for that reason, it's really important and urgent to announce the good news, especially in this world, in this moment. We receive this commandment in our baptism: go to the world and announce the good news. But also, we need more laborers, we need priests, we need vocations. In order to that, we need Catholic and Christian families. If we don't receive the faith in our family from our parents, our good parents, it's more difficult that one young boy discover the vocation to consecrate his life to God, to consecrate his life to the service of God in the church. We need more faith in our families, and before we need families. That is the problem in our society. They want to destroy family. If we don't have families, we don't have vocations. If we don't have vocations, we don't have priests. If we don't have priests, who proclaim the gospel? Who celebrate the sacraments? Who open the heavens, the gates of heavens for us? Because this is the celebration of the Eucharist and the other sacraments. The grace of God come to us. And we need a minister, we need a priest. We have difficulties and crises in our society. But you and me, we receive a mission the day of our baptism. The mission to be witness of Jesus Christ, especially in this world. Announce the gospel with your witness and with your words when it's necessary. And now it's necessary and urgent. Many people need to listen to the good news. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Jesus is present in our life. Jesus is present right now, here with us. Between us, when two or more come and pray together to God Jesus' presence. Jesus' presence in his church, and especially in the Eucharist. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. The Lord is here. And we need to announce the good news to other ones, because many people need listen this. And it's our mission. Perseverance, resist, and announce the good news. We need that news. We need that word in our life, especially the new generations, especially the young people. Let us pray in silence. Now, with confidence, we present our petitions to God.
For the church during this holy season, as she seeks out her own who have become lost, for the spiritual success of penance services and come home for Christmas programs, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace, that world leaders may hear and heed the voice of the divine teacher who points out the right way in the depths of their hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That laborers may be sent into the Lord's harvest with authority over evil and the power to heal and bless. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are in need of compassionate intercession, the sick, the brokenhearted, and those who weep, that the Lord may be gracious to them and bind up their wounds of soul and body. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our loved ones who have completed their long season of Advent with the end of their earthly pilgrimage, that they may see face to face the one they have always desired. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for the families in this parish community. We pray for vocations to religious life and priesthood. Here in this parish community, let us pray to the Lord. And we pray for our personal intentions. Let us pray to the Lord. Father, all good things come from you. Make our hearts ready this season of Advent to make the way straight for you through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Look at the whole creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the sacrifice of our worship, Lord, we pray, be offered to you unceasingly to complete what was begun in sacred mystery, and powerfully accomplish for us your saving work. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Amen. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the gate of eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we will watch for that day, may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts of the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as we doubt and we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have felt us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, peccata mundi, dona nobis pace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am unworthy and you shall enter on the matter. I only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. We implored your mercy, Lord, that this divine sustenance may cleanse us of our faults and prepare us for the coming feasts through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.